I'm interested in researching how ordinary people make financial decisions. People are being given responsibility for increasingly complicated areas of financial decision making. A lot of people are turning naturally to financial advisors to get help. One of the interesting things is that clients are continuing to trust financial advisors, even though the quality of the advice that they're getting may not be very good. We constructed an experiment where we showed clients videos of actors pretending to be financial advisors and giving good and bad financial advice on a series of different topics, and then we studied the way that this trust relationship developed. The study brought out two really interesting findings. The first was that credentials really matter. So the qualifications of the financial advisor influenced people to continue to trust them, independent of the advice that they gave and independent of the characteristics of the advisors themselves. So qualifications matter. The second thing we found was that clients' formation of trust in an advisor can be easily manipulated by first impressions or a confirmation strategy. If the advisor gave clear and good advice on an easy topic early in the relationship, such as paying off your credit card or consolidating your superannuation accounts, the client continued to trust that advisor even though they might have been given bad advice on a harder topic later in the relationship. The financial advice sector in Australia is currently undergoing significant change. The government has put forward proposals to ensure that financial advisors have degrees and undertake ongoing professional development, and that they register so that clients and firms can check that a financial advisor is properly qualified. The government is moving financial advice for individuals towards a fee-based system where there's less opportunity for financial advisors to be influenced by commissions or kickbacks. Ordinary people looking for financial advisors are doing a good thing. It can be very helpful when you're faced with complicated decisions, such as how to manage your wealth during retirement. Your financial advisor should be taking all your personal circumstances into account, and that they give you a plan that's fitted to that. It's important to beware if you feel that an advisor is pushing you towards a product or a plan that you're not entirely comfortable with. Maybe it's time to look for a different advisor.